In this video, we are going to discuss femoral triangle. So first of all, we'll discuss the boundaries of the femoral triangle. So we know that the femoral triangle is a triangular shaped depression which is formed in the upper one third of the thigh. It is formed immediately below the inguinal ligament. So the base of the triangle is formed by the inguinal ligament, and which are the medial and lateral boundaries. So lateral boundary is formed by a muscle . So which is this muscle? This is the sartorius muscle. So the sartorius muscle forms the lateral boundary of this triangle. The medial border of sartorius muscle is forming the lateral boundary of the triangle. Now we look at the medial boundary. So medially it is bounded by another muscle. This muscle is the adductor longus muscle. So the medial border of adductor longus muscle is forming the medial boundary of the triangle. So we see the apex here. The apex is formed by a point where the lateral and medial boundary meet each other. So this is a triangle here. You can see a triangle which is formed in the upper one third of the thigh. The base is formed by inguinal ligament. The lateral boundary is formed by the medial border of sartorius muscle. The medial boundary is formed by medial border of adductor longus muscle. So which are the boundaries here? Base, medial border, lateral boundary, laterally by, now the apex. So these are the boundaries of the triangle. So base is formed by inguinal ligament. Medial, this is the base. Medial boundary, medially it is bounded by medial border of adductor longus muscle. So this is the lateral boundary, it is formed by medial border of sartorius. Apex is formed by the point where the medial and lateral boundaries are meeting each other. Now the apex is continuous downwards with the adductor canal. So this is the femoral triangle, and which all structures are forming the floor of the triangle. So contents which are forming the floor of triangle. So we look at one by one. First of all, lateralmost structure which forms the floor is adductor longus itself. So the adductor longus muscle is forming the medial boundary of this triangle as well as the floor of the triangle. So adductor, first structure, is the adductor longus muscle, adductor longus. And lateral to adductor longus, we have a muscle here. This muscle is the pectineus muscle. So which is this muscle? It's a pectineus. And lateral to the pectineus, we have a tendon, that is tendon of psoas major muscle. So this is tendon of psoas major. And lateral to the tendon of psoas major, another muscle which forms the floor, this is iliacus. So which are the muscles forming the floor? Adductor longus, tendon of psoas major, third is iliacus, sorry, second one was pectineus muscle, So these are the four structures which forms the floor of the triangle. Now we'll discuss about the roof of this triangle. The triangle is bounded by a roof. So actually the roof is formed by structures which are lying superficial to triangle. So which are the structures lying superficial to triangle? So we'll discuss the roof one by one. Which are the structures lying superficial to a triangle? Of course, we know that the skin and superficial fascia is lying over the triangle. So, skin superficial fascia will form the roof. And this triangle is lying to deep fascia. So, deep fascia also forms the roof. Now, the cribriform fascia and the saphenous opening. Fascia and saphenous opening. Now, which are the other structures forming the roof? For that, we'll draw the diagram again here. So, this is the triangle. This is a triangle. We know that the great saphenous vein passes medially to the lower limb and it ascends upwards and it enters through the saphenous opening and it joins the femoral vein here. So the saphenous vein is at first superficial to the femoral triangle, then it passes through the saphenous opening to open into the femoral vein. So great saphenous vein is lying superficial to triangle and it also forms the roof of this triangle. So roof is also formed by great saphenous vein. Now we know that the femoral triangle has femoral vein and femoral artery as its contents. So the branches of femoral artery, that is the superficial branches of femoral artery, like this is a superficial. So external pudendal, this is a superficial external pudendal, superficial epigastric and superficial circumflex iliac. These are the three superficial branches of femoral artery, and there are some tributaries of femoral vein which are accompanying the corresponding branches of femoral artery. This is a superficial external pudendal vein, this is a superficial epigastric vein, this is a superficial circumflex iliac vein. So we can say that the superficial branches of femoral artery and its accompanying veins, superficial branches of femoral artery and its accompanying veins are lying on superficial to femoral triangle and thus forms the roof of triangle. Veins. So they can mention the names of this vessels also, that is superficial external pudendal vessels, superficial epigastric vessels and superficial circumflex iliac vessels. Now we know that there are certain lymph nodes which are present here. These are the superficial inguinal lymph nodes which forms the roof. It's superficial inguinal lymph nodes. Now you can see two nerves here which forms the roof. Which are the two nerves here? So the first one is the this is the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Another one is the ilioinguinal nerve. These two nerves, that is the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve and see the nerve here, this is ilioinguinal nerve. So we have so far discussed about the boundaries of the triangle, the floor of the triangle and roof of the triangle. Now we'll discuss about the important part, that is the contents of the femoral triangle. We are going to discuss about the contents of femoral triangle. So this is a structure. The inguinal ligament, which forms the base of the triangle, the boundaries, boundaries, arteries, and adductor longus muscle. Now, the femoral triangle contains the femoral vein, the femoral artery, and the femoral nerve as the main contents. Now, how is it arranged? From medial to lateral side, it is arranged. We can use a mnemonic, that is VAN. VAN, V stands for femoral vein. A stands for femoral artery, N stands for femoral nerve. That is arranged, that is arrangement from medial to lateral side. So the first structure which is present medially is the femoral vein here. So lateral to the femoral vein, we have the femoral artery. Now the femoral vein and the femoral artery are enclosed in a fascial sheath, which is actually an extension of the two layers of fascia of the abdomen. This fascial sheath is known as the femoral sheath, which covers the upper 4 cm of the femoral vein and the femoral artery. So upper 4 cm of the vein and the artery is covered by a fascial sheath, which is known as the femoral sheath. So this is the femoral sheath. Now you can see lateral to the artery we have femoral nerve and its branches. So this is the femoral nerve and its branches. So which are the contents from medial to lateral? First one is the femoral vein. Second one is the femoral artery with its branches, femoral vein with its tributaries. Femoral artery with its branches. Now, femoral nerve and branches. These are the main contents. There are other three nerves which are present here. We shall discuss about the nerves first. So, one nerve which is a branch of this femoral nerve, which is arising above the inguinal ligament, it passes posterior to the femoral sheath and it supplies and reaches the anterior aspect of pectineus muscle. That nerve is known as nerve to pectineus, which forms the content. Nerve to pectineus, it arises from the femoral nerve above the inguinal ligament, passes posterior to femoral sheath and supplies and reaches the anterior aspect of pectineus. Fifth nerve, this nerve lies in very close relation to femoral artery inside the femoral sheath and it pierces the lateral aspect of the femoral sheath. That is known as the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. Femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. And there is another nerve which is running across the lateral angle of the femoral triangle and it supplies the anterolateral aspect of the thigh and also lateral aspect of gluteal region. So that nerve is the, this is the lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh. So that is lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh. and other glands are, so these three nerves, nerve to pectineus, femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve, lateral cutaneous nerve of thigh, and the deep inguinal lymph nodes are also forming the content. So these are the contents of the femoral triangle. Now we see that the femoral vein and artery are enclosed in the femoral sheath. So now we will discuss about the femoral sheath. Some words about the femoral sheath here. So we have the femoral vein and the femoral artery here. So actually the femoral sheath is a funnel shaped sleeve of fascia enclosing the upper 4 cm of the femoral vein and the femoral artery. So it is actually a funnel shaped sleeve of fascia. So the funnel shaped sleeve of fascia, which is enclosing the upper 3 to 4 cm of the femoral vein and the femoral artery. So, what is this femoral sheath? So the sheath is formed actually by the downward extension of 2 layers of fascia of the abdomen. So it has got an anterior wall and a posterior wall. It is actually formed by 2 layers of fascia of abdomen. So it has got an anterior wall, posterior wall. So the anterior wall is formed by a fascia, that is transversalis fascia of the abdomen. And posterior wall is formed by fascia iliaca. So these two fascia, the extension of these two fascia forming the femoral sheath actually. And inferiorly, what happens to this femoral sheath? Inferiorly, it merges with the connective tissue of the femoral vessels. Inferiorly, it merges with the connective tissue around femoral vessels. So now we see that the femoral sheath is asymmetrical, that the lateral boundary of the femoral sheath is vertical and the medial wall is oblique and it is directed downwards and laterally. So it is divided into 3 compartments actually. So we can see that this compartment, this is the medial most compartment which is lying medial to the femoral vein. So this much part, the medial most compartment, is known as the medial or lymphatic compartment. And now the compartment which contains the vein is known as the intermediate compartment or venous compartment. Intermediate or venous compartment. And the lateral most compartment is known as the lateral or arterial compartment. So look at the medial compartment. Now the medial compartment is known as the medial most compartment of the femoral sheath is called the femoral canal. This is the femoral canal. You see that the femoral canal is conical in shape. Conical in shape. So you can see that it is wide above and narrow below, and the length is 1.5 centimeter, and at the base it is 1.5 centimeter wide. So this, you can see that the base of the femoral canal is known as the femoral ring. You can see a ring here. This is known as the femoral ring. So the base is called femoral ring. So conical shape the structure here. You can see that that is lateral to the vein. We have the femoral canal. The upper, that is base of this, is bound by this. So it has got an anterior, the femoral ring has got an anterior boundary, and it has got a lateral boundary, sorry, medial boundary, and it has got a lateral boundary, and there is a posterior boundary also. This is the femoral ring. So what are the boundaries of the femoral ring here? Boundaries are, so you can see that the anterior boundary is formed by the inguinal ligament. This is the inguinal ligament. Boundary is formed by inguinal ligament. Posteriorly, you can see pectineus muscle and the fascia covering the pectineus muscle. Posteriorly, pectineus and fascia covering this. So medially, this is the medial margin of lacunar ligament. Medial margin of lacunar ligament. So you can see laterally, it is boundary is formed by a septum which is separating it from the facial vein. So laterally, septum separating it from facial vein. So these are the boundaries of the femoral ring. The femoral ring is the base of this femoral canal. It is through this ring that the femoral hernia descends into the femoral triangle, into the femoral canal. So this is very important. The boundaries of the femoral ring is very important. So what this medial compartment of the femoral sheath contains? The medial compartment is known as the facial canal. Sorry, it is called a femoral canal. So what this femoral canal contains? The content of the femoral canal is, it contains, femoral canal contains lymph node of Glockett, or of Rosenmüller. So this lymph node is draining the glans venous in males and clitoris in females. Besides this, it also contains lymphatics and areolar tissue. So we are discussing the femoral sheath. We have discussed the medialmost compartment, that is the femoral canal. We have discussed the femoral ring also. Now I will discuss the intermediate compartment or venous compartment. So the only content of the intermediate compartment is the femoral vein. Now the lateral compartment of the femoral sheath contains the femoral artery. So besides this femoral artery, in close relation to artery, there is a nerve which is present in the lateral compartment. That nerve which is present close to the artery is the femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So this nerve actually passes near to the artery and it penetrates the lateral wall of the femoral sheath. So the lateral compartment contains femoral artery and femoral branch of genitofemoral nerve. So that's all about femoral sheath. Thank you for watching this video. To see more videos on my channel, please subscribe the channel. Thank you.